My son is afraid of darkness and he has to use the shoehorn to turn on the light and use the bathroom. I could move the light switch, but that would be boring. So let's build an unreasonably complex system and maybe we'll learn something. You walk into a public toilet and the light turns on. Pretty simple concept, right? And it's a usual task for a pyroelectric sensor. So the theory is that the pyroelectric sensor observes passively the area with two infrared slots through the lens. When the heat source, also known as human, comes into the supervised area, it sends a signal to your controller. In my case, there is no need to use a controller because I can adjust sensitivity and the time for which the light is on right on the sensor itself. That's great for some use cases, like when you are passing by the street lamp, but not for the toilet where you can sit for hours, like developing your evil plans, maybe. Because when you're idle, there is not enough infrared difference created and the light will go off after a couple of minutes. Also, I don't really want the light to stay on for minutes during the nighttime, disturbing one's sleep. What if we can adapt an ultrasonic sensor for this task? So the ultrasonic distance sensor works pretty similarly to the bat's sonar. It clicks and listens for an echo of the click. The distance is calculated based on the time between click and echo. Just multiply the time by the speed of sound. If we install it on the ceiling above the toilet, we can set the default distance, and when someone comes, stands, or sits near the target, the distance measured will be less than the default one. Then we can turn on the light. And vice versa, when the distance returns back to normal, we can turn off the light without any additional delays. And that's a huge advantage, but you should remember that this device covers only 15 degrees area in front of it, up to 4 meters, only with some libraries, and it's not very precise. It captures the closest object it can see and it will ignore any changes farther away. The pyroelectric sensor is pretty good at even 7 meters for 120 degrees area. It can detect IR changes in the background, even if there is something close to it like a wall or a curtain. This is how I connect the pyroelectric sensor. I don't need Arduino, but I still have to use a transistor to convert 3.3 working level to 5 volts to turn on the relay. And the ultrasonic one. I just soldered it to the Arduino Pro Mini pins number 3, 4, 5, and 6. Let's look at the code for an ultrasonic sensor. We set up the usual distance, and in the main loop, we read the sensor distance and use a moving average filter to avoid false positives. Then we turn on the relay if the last detection was less than 6 seconds ago. This is what we can't actually afford with the pyroelectric, because it would turn off all the time. So yeah, that works great. Except it wasn't that easy to install because we need really precise positioning so it doesn't capture walls and the door. For our bathroom, the pyroelectric sensor works great because we don't need to stay there for a long time, like on the same place. And it doesn't turn off in the middle of something. I had to cover this part of the lens with a whiteboard marker so it doesn't capture anything that's going on behind the door. So what conclusion can we make? Well, you can definitely use non-standard approaches for solving problems, but make sure that these tools and design decisions suit your needs. In my case, the ultrasonic sensor is a great tool and it really simplifies our lives, saving seconds each day. But in most similar cases, you should still better use good old pyroelectric sensor. Like or dislike this video, share your experience of using these tools in the comments below, and subscribe for more crazy DIY stuff, and my mom will be proud. Well, shit. Need some transparent curtains here.